All of northern India has a huge air pollution challenge for many reasons. One, of course, is the car vehicular pollution. The second is burning of all the stubbles in Punjab, Haryana, and UP. And the third one is all the security guards burning anything which they can lay their hands on in the winter months. And they should not be doing that. Fourth, of course, is Diwali crackers. And the main one, of course, is that people yet have not made up their mind that pollution is an important problem and needs a solution. So today, if one spends full time in a weather or in atmospheric air with PM2.5s even of 2000 microgram per meter cube, one is not going to get sick immediately. It's a very slow process that these particles lodge in the arteries, causing damage in terms of blockages of the arteries and requirements of stents in the future to clean them up. The other one is these particles travel to the pancreas and it creates problems in terms of in getting maybe type 2 diabetes and other issues, other health issues. Blood oxygen levels are measured by an SpO2 meter, which costs electronic meter, which costs a few thousand rupees. So it's easy, and everybody should be encouraged to measure his blood oxygen levels. It should be between 98 and 100. If you're less than 96, I would recommend that the person goes and gets a lung function test in a hospital or in a nursing home. One must make sure that the CO2 levels are under 600 ppm and the VOCs are under 50 microgram. Where are these VOCs coming from? VOCs are coming from perfumes, from deodorants, from dhubbati, agarbatti, from burning any kind of sprays or spraying the house with some chemicals, or from even cleaning the floor with a particular chemical, etc. So one should really watch out. My suggestion is that you focus on your bedroom, where you spend one third or one fourth of your life, to make sure that is the sacred room where you have perfect air quality, so that your cognitive abilities are extremely high and you are successful.